Why aren't all power lines underground? There are two ways Vector gets power around Auckland: underground lines and overhead lines. 55% of customers have power lines underground in front of their homes in the Auckland region. All new developments in the region have power lines underground, as the site works for construction and road building typically provide easy and cost-efficient access to install the lines. Underground lines are more resilient to tree damage, but can still be damaged by storms if trees are uprooted. Unfortunately, contractors and DIYers sometimes hit underground cables, causing damage. You should request underground plans at least 2 working days before starting work. Visit vector.co.nz/safework to find out how. When something goes wrong with an underground line, it usually takes a lot longer to fix because we have to dig until we find the fault. Undergrounding also costs up to 10 times more per kilometre than power poles and lines. Costs are particularly high in areas built on hard volcanic rock, which is common in central Auckland. In rural areas, undergrounding power lines is prohibitively expensive, given the lower population numbers per kilometre. And that cost ultimately ends up with consumers, which is why we still use power poles in some cases. They're affordable and easy to repair if something goes wrong. They're more prone to damage from vehicle accidents and storms, though, especially if trees aren't properly managed. At Vector, we use the technology that's best for each area, and that helps keep costs down for our customers, which is why Auckland has both underground lines and power poles.